Yeah, hello, my name is Tobias, and I'm one of the main developer of the Android app, and I want to show you the next upcoming features of the Android Nextcloud app. Currently, you have to download an image if you want to view it, and depending on your camera size, you have roughly about 5 or 8 MB per each image. And if you just want to download it to share it with via WhatsApp or Facebook, it doesn't even is necessary. It is better to have a smaller version. And if you want to show some of your friends your complete vacation history with about 1,000 images, you run very soon in a space problem. The solution is to use a device adapted images, and they are screen dependent and are rough about 50 kilobyte each image. And they're stored in a cache, and it's enough for sharing with WhatsApp or uploading it to Facebook. And you can zoom in just about the factor of 2 to enhance some images. It's a new feature, and if you use it for the first time, you can disable it via the snack bar, so you can still have the old system and the old behavior. And of course, you can download each image manually, so you can print it out or do whatever you want with a full resolution image. And to compare it, you can see on the left side you have 100 images and they are taking up to 500 MBs, and on the right side you have the 5 MB cache of 100 images. The next thing is, as you saw on the last page, that the Nextcloud folder can grow very big, and especially on mid-size devices, the internal space is very limited, and there was many issues reported that the Nextcloud folder should be moved to the external storage, and this will be done on the next version. You can choose it in the settings, and the existing folder will be migrated to the external storage or any arbitrary folder you define. And also, the images are still in the gallery app, so you can just use them as the way before. Currently, you can see the files you have in the file detail list with file size or modification date, or you can switch to the grid view. And it is hard-coded currently for 4 columns in the landscape and in the portrait models, and in the landscape for 6 columns. And if you just want to show quick some enhanced images, you can now do it with a pinch zoom to show more details of some images, or the other way around to show less details and more columns to get a quick overview and browse thousands of folders, images in one folder to see where the images you are looking for. This is a pinch zoom, and it will be available also on the next version. For fresh installations, we want to show a quick overview of the main 4 features of the Nextcloud app, and it just shows an intro which can be skippable, and it shows the main features. But we want to show it also for the upgrading of existing users. They should see the major features, or we want to promote hidden features like the pinch zoom. It's not obviously that this pinch zoom exists, so we need to make sure that the users know that it even exists to use it. But of course, as Jan said, we should not promote every single feature or even show a changelog. So we want to show the major features of the new version. What is coming next is also to map or to enhance the sync so that we can map even any folder on the mobile phone to the next folder to, for example, backup your WhatsApp image folder. And currently we want to do it first in one direction to replace the instant upload and also save solve the Android 7 problem. So we want just to go from a mobile to server. And in the later versions, we want to do a full two-way sync with also conflict management and limitation to VLAN or charging only. And in the longer term, we want to support also the real offline functionality to or that allows you that you can use the app when you're on the train or on the plane where you do not have any data plan. And also we want to enhance the navigation drawer to show downloads like we are currently doing for uploads, and also show the sharing folders or present the activity stream which is currently on the server. And the last two points are more generally to improve the performance if we if you open folders with lots of thousand images, and also do UI and UX experience enhancements. If you want to help us, you are lucky, and you can just visit the contribution file on GitHub. Thank you.